David, very nice to meet
nice
you today.
To meet you.
David Bagby, the
Thank
CEO
you.
Of Alliance Memory. For me, it's fascinating and fantastic that for the first time I am able to talk with somebody who is representing the legacy business here, right?
Yes.
So I would like you to tell me how do you find embedded and all the solutions you are seeing here? They are evolving so rapidly.
Yes.
So is there anything that surprises even you?
Yeah, you know, the whole embedded world and what we're here today to learn and see and witness, it's really amazing because, you know, from Alliance perspective, we started out as a legacy supplier and kind of doing everything that a Samsung and Micron doesn't want to do. That's what we did, and that we specialized in that. And now over the years, we've been around 18 years now servicing memory, and we probably have 4,000 or 5,000 customers in the Europe area. So we're seeing all those customers today, and we're trying to introduce the high-end technology as well. So not only, even though we advertise legacy, we don't want to get away from that because customers, especially in Europe, want that. We are now introducing the higher end technology, so we're trying to get that word out as well.
So you are trying to merge two realities. Still they are merged, cooperating.
You've got the biggest suppliers in the world and they do not offer the product offering that we actually offer. Our breadth of our portfolio is really the best DRAM offering in the world. And then if you look at our static RAM offering, there's not really anybody else that does it.
Yeah.
So we're still legacy, we're not growing new products in that, but we're certainly servicing the market on that.
Is there anything misinterpreted or misunderstood in the products you are offering or in the business you're in?
I think maybe the only thing I would say would be that they don't think of us as the high-end stuff. Their customers are still thinking Micron and Samsung might be the only sources out there, and it's like, hey, we're here, you know, we can support you too. So that's what we try to do, and that's why we're at the show, was to try to do things like that.
But actually, the memory chips and the legacy memory chips are in businesses which are extremely important. They are everywhere, and they are the base that people don't want to change because this is so reliable, this is so sophisticated, and there is no need for that change.
Right.
Right?
No, and that's where we come into play.
Yeah, yeah.
We don't do DRAM changes. You look at our competitors, most of them are changing every 6 to 9 months.
Yeah.
We don't do that. I mean, our customer base is industrial and even specifically medical. I mean, these guys want the same part for the next 10 to 15 years, which we're offering that to them.
I read about NASA and about their satellites, that what they actually are focused on is that the thing in reaction with the atmosphere or with the action of the cosmic things, it cannot change because they can't afford it to change,
right?
So that's why it's so reliable for me.
Yeah, no, for sure. Yeah.
And as you are mentioning different industries like automotive, medical, which industry is pushing the boundaries so much that you say, wow, people, you have guts to do that?
Right. Well, I mean, I get it. It's probably things that we actually don't do, the AI space that's going on right now. So I would say that what's going on is the big companies are pushing those boundaries and it's dragging the supply chain to that service that market, which is maybe 10 customers in Europe that are driving that.
Yeah.
So what else do these 5,000, 10,000 customers in Europe do? Because Micron, Samsung, Hynix are going to do those 10 customers. So what's left for everybody else? And that's where we come into play.
Do you remember any, or have you ever been excited about any project that really like spoke to your imagination, that really took you and said, oh, I love it?
Yeah, you know, it's kind of the legacy actually. And I don't mean to say that in a negative way because it's just customers want that and they need that so much. And the bigger suppliers don't do this, don't do what they want them to do. So that's what gets me excited, is to go reach out to these customers and tell them we're going to support them for the next 10 years, where nobody else in this building is saying that.
Do you yourself, are you using those memory chips? Somewhere.
Oh, me myself.
Yeah, yourself.
I mean, we got them in television sets. We got them in home security. We're not at, so anything electronics is a potential customer of ours for sure. So it reaches out to everything.
And what sets your solution apart from the existing ones?
Again, no DRAM changes is kind of our key. Staying in business long term. consistent pricing. I mean, you're not going to see a whole bunch of memory suppliers that will say, we'll give you the same price for the rest of this year. Mm-hmm. And let alone some suppliers won't even commit to next week at the same price. So,
right. So
I think consistent pricing, same die rev changes, support, you can count on us. And
again, you mentioned at the very beginning of the camera that your son is here and he is going to take over the company, right? So
Yeah. If
he comes, I would like to talk to him. But this kind of generational change, are you proud of that? That you have a company and you have somebody to leave it to?
Well, I am. So I'll let him speak to that. But yes, I'm super excited to make that transition over or try to make the transition over. He's got to earn it, of course. But after being in this industry for 35 years or so, always in the memory space, and this is my baby, I'm not going away from it. But, you know, we want to make sure and assure our suppliers that we have a good succession plan, if you will. We're a private company, which makes us unique in carrying a lot of inventory and be able to do the same price for a year. Because if we were a public company, we couldn't do that, right?
Yeah.
We couldn't carry a lot of inventory. We'd have to change the price if the price changed. But we're very unique. We can do whatever we want.
And that's another trust factor for customers, that there
Absolutely.
Is this transition. And they can rely on you, and they are hopefully relying on the future generation.
Well, absolutely. Yeah.
So I've got actually a few more questions, and these are specific.
Okay.
Because we are asking our viewers to ask some questions. And actually, some of them are created by the viewers. So we spoke about the niche, but for me, the most interesting was what makes you ready to deliver the product to the market? Somebody asked a question, what makes you ready to deliver the product to the market and how does it happen?
Yeah, right. So I think what we try to do proactively is not just carry finished goods inventory. Everybody says, this is what I got inventory, but it's really having the wafer inventory. So. Once you have a wafer, then you don't have to worry about a fab. You just have to worry about us putting assembly, putting the leads on it and testing it and making it a finished good. So we pride ourselves not only on having finished goods inventory, but also wafer inventory.
Okay.
So maybe 1 year of finished goods, 1 year of wafer, we got 2 years of supply.
Is there any kind of memory that is sick today, that is hot today actually? Any specific?
Yeah, well, I think right now the hot button in the industry is EMMC.
Okay.
So EMMC is very tricky right now because there's not very many NAND suppliers that make the flash that goes in the EMMC. And Samsung, which is the biggest one, just announced EOL. So a lot of customers are very panicked on EMMC. So I would say half the customers today coming to the show are asking us about EMMC.
All right. And if how can you predict the future for memory chips? Is it going to change much? Because you know what is interesting? I was asking ChatGPT about memory chips before this interview. And it showed me a chip done by Russia, the very first one, woven by hand. So on the part, there were just like copper wires and somebody was like stitching it on it. So how will the future look like? Is it going to change much? Or is it going to be not exchange, but there is going to be another generation for it?
Well, it is going to change because I mean the memory market is a beautiful thing. It's up and down and we can always count on that. So it's going to happen. And why does it happen? It happens because it's dominated by three suppliers. So Samsung, Micron, Hynix is 90% of the market, 90.
Okay.
So if these guys want to change it, they have the ability to change it. And they do. Whether they're moving capacity over to AI, like I mentioned earlier, which leaves us able to capture all the low-hanging fruit, if you will. But that's how it's going to change. It's going to change because there's main drivers that are driving it.
And the last thing I found about it was I wanted to summarize it somehow, and every source was saying old but gold. And I didn't like this old, so I was trying to find some synonym, and every source started saying reliable and gold.
Legacy,
right? That's
right,
trustworthy and gold.
Yeah.
All packed.
Yes.
The whole package.
No, so that's how we, I mean, we say all those things about us. Mm-hmm. And I think if you surveyed our customers, they would say that about us too, so.
Uh-huh. Do you survey them sometimes?
For sure, yes.
Yeah? What are they saying? What stays in your mind if somebody said anything? Okay.
I think for sure it's one thing, just consistent, reliable support.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, so, and that's what we try to be.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I've worked for Samsung and Hitachi, these big giant companies, and you know, they're not as customer focused as us. I mean, we want to do what the customer wants.
Okay, so you listen, you draw conclusions, and you put it into action.
It's our strength, yes.
Great, so that seems the recipe for the best business you could have ever done.
Yep.
Thank you very much,
Thank
David.
You.
Thank you.